delightful. The jewels of Hakon are using these bones in a warding spell.
It could be blood magic. Let's look for any more skulls.
Barbwood, a parasitic tree that grows through the body of its host. Useful in alchemy, makes terrible furniture.
What sort of uses does it have?
The sap makes potent restorative potions. Extracts from the leaves are useful for transmutations. Harvesting either one is too dangerous to attempt often. More's the pity.
Hunting, following a scent. Something good, fresh, a treat, then trapped, nets and clubs and pain. She's nearby, caged, cramped, can't get free. We need to help her. trees are fighting. They're very angry, but very slow. Your uncle misses you, Cassandra.
Picked that up from my head, did you?
No. He wrote you a letter. There was pain on the page.
Stop going into my quarters. How many times must I tell you?
Thank you. See any wares you like?
Farewell.
Another time. See any wares you like?
Farewell.
Goat-kissing, blood-drinking, hackneyed chicken craps! Thank you, Inquisitor. Storvaker has returned. My hunters saw what you and she did to the Hakonites who held her. In trapping Storvaker, the jaws of Hakon broke their peace oath with Stonebear Hold. Our blades are yours.
We're going to need those blades to deal with the Hakonites.
More than you know, Inquisitor. My hunters brought items back from where they held Storvaker. I know what they intended. It is not something you will like. Something few Avar would tell Lowlanders. But you must hear it. The jaws of Hakon sought to bind their god in mortal form and bring war to the Lowlands.
A god's god?
Yes. Hakon Winter's Breath, bringer of the cold winds of war.
How do you send a god to attack someone?
With much blood and many foolish rituals. Though you have given them pause, they will try again. Ages ago, the old jaws of Hakon did the same. They brought their god to life to destroy the Lowlands. Their foolishness lost Hakon to all Avar. Now they would free him and begin again.
What did you mean when you said that their foolishness lost Hakon to all Avar?
When they bound Hakon to mortal form, he became blood of this world. He could hear no prayers, nor speak to the augurs. All he could do was kill. Then he vanished instead of dying, as though rendered mute, lost for ages. If they sought to free him from mortal form, I could understand. Making him attack the Lowlands is a fool's work.
The Avar wouldn't like the idea of war with the Lowlands.
Is that what your skalds say? It does us no harm to be feared. If our land is threatened, we will happily fight. And a raid here and there keeps both sides sharp. But we have no need of your Lowlands. Not when our goats are fat and our fish are plenty. And not when the sky is torn with demons. Only a fool fights in a burning boat.
What would happen if the jaws of Hakon succeeded in their plan?
Hakon would come to the Lowlands in the form of a great beast. The Hakonites would join him, their numbers swelled by foolish young warriors dreaming of honor names. Even if war were needed, it should not be like that, with gods wreaking havoc in blood-soaked fields. The gods should stay where they belong.
Based on what we know, what must we do to stop the jaws of Hakon?
Their hold is an old Lowlander fortress. It is shielded by a great wall of ice. Magic even the Hakonites do not know. Unravel its magic, and we will scatter their bones so the Lady never finds them.
We still need a way to melt the wall of ice around the Hakonites' fortress. Do you have any ideas?
No. It is Lowlander magic and nothing to do with us. Our spirit talkers are useless as battle goats. The Hakonites must have found the magic in the old fortress. Speak to your people. Perhaps they will know more.
We still need a way to melt the wall of ice around the Hakonites' fortress. Do you have any ideas?
No. It is Lowlander magic and nothing to do with us. Our spirit talkers are useless as battle goats. The Hakonites must have found the magic in the old fortress. Speak to your people. Perhaps they will know more.
I will speak with you later.
Walk with the Lady's blessing.